Okay, but this was your dream role we hear. Tell us about that.
Absolutely. I mean, these are the kinds of things I watched growing up as a kid. Yeah. You know, everything from Michael Keaton's Batman to Wesley Snipes' Blade, like the superhero genre is my thing.
Yeah.
So to be able to do it now as an adult and having my childhood dream sort of mesh with that,
yeah,
there's no better feeling.
What did it feel like actually watching the film and seeing it all play out?
It felt great. I was a little nervous because I don't like watching myself, and now, like, I don't like the way I sound or look on camera, but you know, I had some friends who had a really good time, and you know, just sort of loosened me up to everything.
Yeah.
It was surreal, you know.
Oh, cool.
And being in the CGI onesie the entire time, it was nice to see the final product.
Yeah, you know, I went and saw the movie the other day, and for someone who doesn't geek out action films, this is a movie for everyone, I think. It really had my attention the whole time. It was so good. Tell us a little bit about how Cyborg fits into this movie.
I think Cyborg represents the film on the whole. You know, he's able to take the negative situations in his life and put them to the side to become a part of the team again.
Yeah.
And I think that's something that resonates with all of the characters. You know, each of these superheroes is sort of living in a half world. You know, you've got their alter egos and you've got what their superhero personality is. And I think Cyborg is one of the best representations of that because he is Cyborg and Victor Stone simultaneously. He can't take off the costume.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, so.
Well, even though Cyborg is CGI, we do see on your Instagram and social media that you want to get into superhero shape yourself anyway, right?
Yeah.
There you are working out, and I think you hit every muscle there. So a lot of working out for this film?
There was a lot, yeah. And that's a testament to Zack Snyder, our director, and making sure that we are as accurate to our comic iteration as we possibly can be. You know, we were training like madmen, you know, for 6 months in the gym. Ezra Miller, who plays our Flash, Jason Momoa, who plays Aquaman, and there was an army of really, really talented Themyscirans or Amazon warriors in the gym with us as well.
Oh, wow.
And I mean, having everybody in there, there's sort of like a sort of team effort.
Yeah, no stunt doubles on this.
There's stunt doubles for sure. But you know, Jason does his own stunts, and there's a lot of work that goes into just the shape of it. So I was really fortunate, really blessed to be able to work with the people that I was able to work with.
Cool. You tweeted out recently that you have your own emoji, which is pretty cool. But are you ready for action figures, lunchboxes, T-shirts, everything that goes on?
I'm excited for it. Yeah, I'm excited. I'm excited for my mom to have them. She's going around like trying to buy up all the action figures, and you know, I've got a nephew who's one. Oh yeah. She's going around. I've got a nephew who's 1 year old now, and you know, he's too young to sort of appreciate having an uncle that has an action figure.
Yeah.
And hopefully, I'll still be cool by the time he.
Yeah. Every Christmas you'll be like,
I'm about a cyborg. Like, no, give me Batman. I want Batman.
And your family is loving you right now. I mean, you went to the premiere last night. You took the entire family with you?
I took the entire family, my brothers, my sisters, my mom. It was a blast. You know, it was sort of like a wheel coming full circle.
Yeah.
They've been with me.
I was going to say, they were part of this journey, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Everything from the days I could see myself as a starving actor to driving me to the bus so I could come to New York and do auditions. Like, since day one, and you know, it's nice to be able for them to be able to share in that moment.
And they keep you grounded.
And they keep you grounded.
They're like, don't you become a big star.
What's funny is when I watch things with them that I'm in, you know, they laugh at me first and foremost. Anytime I pop up on screen, they're like, look at me. And once it settles down, you know, I'm like, okay, that's embarrassing.
Yeah. Well, and you're not the only new face in this film either. Jason Momoa as Aquaman is new. Did the veterans give you guys any advice?
Honestly, it was such a collaborative effort stepping into the scene, you know, with Zach and the way that he runs his whole crew. It feels like you're stepping into a family.
Yeah.
You know, everybody was super welcoming. This is my first film, period, let alone a film of this caliber.
Yeah.
And so, you know, we bonded really quickly. It's really good introduction. It's really good. And it's nice to have that sort of safety net, right?
Yeah.
To have each other's backs in that way,
yeah.
No matter what happens.
Yeah, well, congratulations on everything.
Thank you.
All right, well, you can get Ray and Justice League, which hit theaters.